Hi everybody, this is Nick. I'm going to show you today how you can connect an Excel file to a Microsoft form so that data automatically feeds into it. Now, I think we're all used to making Microsoft forms. We make them, we send them out, we collect the data, we go to the responses tab, and we continue to download that Excel data and then put it into and then paste it over into some master file. But this way, we can actually connect the form and the Excel file so that data automatically feeds into our Excel document. Now, the trick is you have to create the form by starting from Excel. You can't create the form by starting from the regular Forms app. So we're going to open a new Excel file. It also has to be an Excel for the web. So you have to have your Excel file open on the web, not in the desktop app. And it should be saved in your OneDrive, your SharePoint, or a Teams file. So right now I have this new workbook right here. It's open in Excel for the web. And what I want to do to create the form is go to the Insert tab, and you'll notice that you have this Forms dropdown. So I'm going to click on that. We're going to click on New Form. It automatically opens a form and it names the form the exact same thing as your workbook. Now, I don't want it to be guest experience survey data on the actual survey, so I'm just gonna go ahead and delete that data piece. And now what you'll do is, just like you're creating a normal form, you will go ahead and start creating the form right here. So I'm just gonna create one question: please rate your overall experience at the museum today. And then we'll add our rating. Now, of course, you're probably going to have more questions that you'll add, but this is going to be, oops, for good demonstration purposes here. Good, excellent, and outstanding. All right, now I've created my one question in my survey, and just like a regular form, you can go to the responses tab. We haven't collected any responses. I'm actually gonna go over here, and what we'll do is we're gonna collect responses. What I wanna do first is I'm actually gonna change some of the settings on this, because I want anybody in the world to be able to respond. I don't want just people in my organization to respond, and I don't want it to collect email addresses and names like that. So I'm just gonna say anyone can respond, and I'm just gonna make sure that the accept responses tab is open. Okay, perfect. We're gonna collect the responses. I'm going to copy that URL, and we're just going to do a few sample responses here. So I'll paste that in, just like I was a visitor at the museum taking the survey. I'm going to say excellent, and let's just submit a few responses for demonstration purposes here. I'm going to say outstanding, we had a great visit, and then maybe we have one person who did not like their visit and they gave it a poor. Okay, so now I've collected some of my data. And now over here in my form tab, you can see that on the responses, I have four responses collected. You can go ahead and view the results one by one if you wanted to do that, or you can look at this nice little dashboard with this really not so great pie chart for this rating. Should be a bar chart, I think, Microsoft, so take note of that. Okay, so now what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back to our Excel file. Now when you see we are back in our Excel file, you see the responses have started to populate in. Perfect, so all of that looks really good. The email, it's set to anonymous. That's exactly what I want. The name column, it's always going to have that, but you don't need that, so we can just leave it right there. It also gives you the start time and completion time, and then the data are right there. Now, in this file, we could add a column, maybe just for notes, and I want you to know that that's not going to update anything in the form. So over in the form, when we do this, when we refresh that, you can see there's nothing changed there. But if I want to go back and add a question in real time, I could do that. Let's just say, let's add an open-ended text box. Please explain your rating. And we're going to say it's a long answer question, and now I have that question on my form. Now let's go over to the Excel file and see what that did. You can see that it actually added that, please explain your rating, to the very end. So what is interesting about this is that my notes column is not a question. So this is something that you're gonna have to keep in mind. If you add any additional columns to your Excel file at the end, those are gonna show up somewhere in the middle of the survey if you intend on adding questions to the survey. Now let's just see what happens when I pop, go over here and let's collect responses. Let's do another test response right here. So I'm gonna say outstanding. I loved the museum today, it was great. Let's submit that response, and now let's go back to our Excel file and see if it populated. Yep, it populated my new response right here on that ID number 5, that row number 6, and you can see over here in Please Explain Your Rating, I have the text there. So it's a really cool way that you can, you don't have to constantly export your data in Excel and forms and then put it into a file. You can create your form directly into an Excel file and then have it populate and feed that data right in. So that's a really good tip. I hope that you use it. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and make sure to hit the bell and the subscribe button. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word, and sometimes Microsoft Forms and Survey Design, my other sort of professional passion. I had a great time making this for you. Hope you had a great time watching, and I can't wait to see you all next time.